We are live right now with Shannon Brown, and I'm Ray E.
I'm P. Wills.
It's your boy Duke.
And we are officially here with emerging actor Shannon Brown. Tell us what's going on, Shannon. Talk to us, man.
Nothing much, really. I just got done filming. The latest thing that I filmed was a Star Wars commercial. Mm-hmm. So that was pretty
nice.
Cool.
Nice. Yeah.
They shipped R2-D2 from, I think, London. I think where they said they shipped him from.
Yeah.
Wow, okay. So that was pretty cool. But before that, I shot Training Day with Bill Paxton.
Okay.
That'll be coming up on February 2nd at 8 p.m. on CBS.
Yeah, yeah.
And, yeah, just working on basketball, too, so.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah, okay.
Tell us, so, I mean, you're a man of many talents.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, a lot of people are looking up to you, especially like a lot of the younger kids, because a lot of kids don't really get those opportunities. You know, if I could do anything, I would just say, like, you know, what are some things that you could say to the kids out there that's listening in, that's watching right now, that, you know, to get to the level that you're getting to? I mean, you're an emerging actor doing wonderful things, and you're definitely going to go far. So what do you say to the little kids?
I think what I want to say is, you know, when you want to do something, you got to, you know, go full tilt. Like, don't hold back because you think, you know, you're going to hurt yourself, or, you know, you're going to hold back because you don't know what happened. Just go for it and make sure that what you do is what you want to do, not what somebody else is wanting you to do.
Absolutely, man. Those are good points.
Yes, sir. Points. I mean, and that's good to break the ice. I mean, we've been doing a little bit of research on you. You've been out there, man. You've been around for a minute. You know, there was a you did an interview with Angela Gnote, you know, in 2015. How does it feel to, like, you know, be a part of you know, meeting Lee Daniels and, you know, the whole return, or, you know, Star Wars thing? You know, what does it feel like?
I mean, it feels like super cool. Like, you. Mm. When you're my age, you don't think that, you know, you hope that you want to meet those kind of people. And where I am, that's, this is like a dream come true.
Yeah.
Like, I think when I first started acting, I wanted to be in a Star Wars, anything mm-hmm. Star Wars, mm-hmm. because that was like my whole dream when I was little. And then Empire came out, and I was like, that's the greatest show. Like, everybody loves it. I want to be on that show.
For sure.
Mm. And then when I got that audition, I was like, dude, I'm definitely working super hard on this right now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Good, man. Yeah.
I mean, you know, not only that, you know, Empire, I mean, how was it working on Empire with, I mean, seeing all the celebrity and stars? How does it feel? I mean, a lot of us ain't, you know, we've been in Hollywood and we see actors and stuff going around, but mm-hmm. we don't necessarily get to get on the set and, like, see what's going on. Explain the experience when you're on the set. Like, are you just in a dressing room waiting, or are you just kind of walking around talking to people? Like, what's the experience?
Really, the experience is, So, at first you'll get to set, you'll sign in, and then, your clothes that for, the shooting will be in your trailer. And then mm-hmm. when you go in mm-hmm. there, you get dressed, and you can go and get that crafty. That's where everything is. That's,
right.
That's that crafty.
Yeah.
but then, crafty. But, you know, it's also when you see somebody, you know, you just want to interact, like, you want to talk, you want to be able to make sure that you're getting out there, but you're also having a great time on set, and they make it really fun for you on every set.
Yeah.
When you're a kid, like, it's all fun.
Really? They put, like, the food in a certain area, or they give you out toys, or what? Explain it. Like, what's fun about it?
Like, when you're meeting people, they're like, super nice to you, but, you know, they're also very talkative. They're not going to be, like, mean to you or anything.
For sure.
That's good.
Lee Daniels was awesome. He was really nice to me, and he's really cool.
Mm.
So, yeah, and then I went to the season premiere. And
where was that at? Where was the season premiere?
That was in New York City.
New York City? Wow.
And that was pretty cool because I think that was my first time going to New York City.
Yeah, was it red carpet style?
They actually made it gold because of Empire. It was a gold carpet.
Oh, wow. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Nice.
And I had a suit that had like a lion on the front. And then if you opened it up, it had like a little lion.
Oh, you're flashy, huh?
And then it had a like a lion paw, like a baby cub paw on the back of the suit. So that was pretty cool.
So who are you closest to on the show? Is like being cool with, like you're on the show, on the set?
I think Taraji, she was really nice to me, and she would take me all around at the season premiere, because there was a lot of people on the floor where everybody was, like the whole Empire cast crew, and so I wanted to meet everybody, and Taraji kind of like, you know, directed me towards everybody and introduced me to everybody. She took me to Terrence Howard and introduced me to him. And Terrence was really cool, so I got a picture with everybody on set. So that was really cool.
Nice. Oh, great. So is Taraji like the mother
of the set? Yeah. Pretty much. She's super nice. Like, I'd probably live with her. She's super nice.
Nice, man. That's good to hear.
Who's, if I had to ask, who's your favorite actor? Like, who's somebody you look at and you're like, man, that's what I want to be like. I want my career to go in that direction. Like, that's my favorite actor. Who you look up to?
I look up to a whole bunch of people. So, when it comes to, like, superhero stuff, I look up to Grant Gustin because he's super cool. I mean, he's The Flash, obviously. And I want to be on The Flash someday. But then I also look up to, like, the serious actors and the drama actors and the ones that can, you know, deliver like that and are really good. So, I like to look at Terrence for his facial reactions, or Kelly Rowland, because she was really cool, and Taraji. Also, you know, superhero again, Ryan Reynolds. Mm-hmm. That was pretty... Deadpool was cool. Then, so those are kind of the people I kind of look up to and want to be someday.
Gotcha, man.
How does it feel like going to school and do your friends see you on TV and they're like, I see you on TV? Or is it just like regular kid stuff?
When I first went to Northview, first it started at Nora, but Nora was pretty cool about it because, like, you know, I booked Empire and then it was just like everybody was so cool. Like, nobody was like all over. Just then I got to middle school and it's completely different. it was, you know, I was eating lunch and then some girls came over and asked if they could take a picture.
The girls, huh? Okay, here we go.
Of course, there you go. Yeah, of course.
Lined up.
And then I took a picture with them and, you know, they asked me, you know, who was the nicest person on set, and I obviously said Taraji and, you know, Terrence and them. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's, It kind of dies down after a while, but yeah, I mean, it's really cool going to school at Northview, but, you know, still acting like you're a normal kid, though. But, you know, you obviously know that, you know, there are some people that look up to you and, you know, you just kind of admire that and want to take that in and give all of the, you know, words and... like words of wisdom that you can, and I think that's.
I got a cool question for you. All right, so I know you're an avid basketball. You like basketball. I already know that. You love basketball.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and so if you had a chance, this is my question. If you had a chance to play with your favorite NBA player on the team with them, who would that player be? And the choice is you can play on that team with the NBA player. Or you can play starring role or co-actor role with your favorite actor in any movie it is. Which one would you pick, the basketball or the movie?
Trying to think. That's a hard one. because I love basketball, and then I also love acting.
Mm-hmm. Who would be your favorite player? Like, whose team would you be on?
Paul George.
The Pacers? Paul George?
Paul George.
Great answer. Right, I like
great answer. Great
Paul,
answer.
Where you at? Paul, where you at? You know what I'm saying? We need some lessons, man. We're going to drive out to Geist, man. Knock on the door. We need some lessons, brother. You know, but Paul, he, in the offseason, he's in California, so maybe you'll see him.
Yeah, yeah. I saw him one time at a Denny's. It was pretty cool. Me and my friends were going there, and we saw him. He's super tall. Like, he had mm-hmm. to duck down to get into the door. I was like, man.
Yeah.
So, do you like how the Pacers are playing right now?
Actually, yeah, I do. I mean, like, it really changed since last year, and they've gotten a lot quicker on defense and offense, and you know, they're got more players, and it's, you know, easier to pass around, and I like where their season is going.
Mm-hmm.
I'm praying that this is going to be their year where they can get that one championship trophy.
Okay.
It ain't going to be this
quick.
They're going to have to try a little bit harder.
Hey, really, really quick, though. Do you think that they should have kept George Hill or not?
At some points, I did want them to keep George Hill, because when my brother said, man, they got rid of George Hill like that, I was like, what? Wait, when they get rid of George Hill? I was like, I didn't see that.
Yeah.
I was like, George Hill and Paul George, they were like brothers. You know, they had each other's backs on the court mm-hmm. and everything.
Personally, I think they should have kept him. Yeah. But, you know.
I agree. I mean, I like Teague. You know, he's his own player. You know what I'm saying? I don't have anything negative to say about Teague. He was a good addition.
I do like Teague.
It's just hard to find a chemistry of players that play well together.
I know, and my mom knows his dad.
Okay.
So I go up to his practices sometimes.
Oh, cool.
He practices at my mom's school.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
So, I mean, his dad is really cool, and, you know, he says that Jeff Teague sometimes comes up there sometimes mm-hmm. and,
yeah,
you know, hangs out. So.
Nice.
We got some questions.
Yeah,
you got people chiming in. Mafi said, asked, do you ever want to just be a kid and not work so hard? How do you overcome those moments?
Mm. I mean, I don't think I want to be a normal kid, because, you know, being normal, it's just like, you know, every other life, you know, you're just, you don't get the, you sometimes don't get the opportunities that I'm getting right now, but I mean, there are some points where I have wanted to play basketball or mm-hmm. not be worried about, you know, getting hurt sometimes, but mm-hmm. I mean, I always, you know, get through it, because I know that, God gave me a wonderful talent of getting this far mm-hmm. as a 12-year-old, starting at 7 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. And he got me all the way up here. So, I mean, I don't regret it at all of being,
you
being
shouldn't.
This kid.
Yeah,
you
know,
you shouldn't.
Yeah, you know, everyone's path, you know, we all have different paths. And it just seems as though you want to, you know, just tap, you know, keep tapping into your talents. And just have an extraordinary life. You know, you just don't want to breathe air. You know, you want to make an impact in some way, shape, or form. So, you know, that's a beautiful thing.
And you're also an inspiration for kids all over, you know. Yeah. So how did you get started? I mean, like, did you just...
I went to a IPS school here in Indiana called School 70.
Okay.
And we had theater class there. And my theater teacher would always use me as a kind of an example for her older kids, like fifth graders, younger kids, because she knew that I had, she was like, I can see it in him. He's really good. I always use him. Then she told my mom to get me into acting and get me a manager and stuff. And at first, my mom kind of pushed it away because, you know, we didn't really do the acting stuff. We did basketball. We did sports,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Mm.
Then she kept on bugging my mom's friend from college or high school, can't remember.
mm-hmm.
And she finally said yes, and I went to Chicago, and I auditioned for the movie Setup with Bruce Willis and 50 Cent, and booked it right off the thing, right off the bat. So my mom was like, oh, well, maybe he can do it. And my mom said, well, if we're going to do this, we're going full tilt. And she was like, full tilt is California, so let's get out to California, get you a manager, get you an agent.
Nice. Wow. That's awesome. Man, that's incredible.
Get you headshots and stuff, figure out what to do in this acting business stuff, and see if you can get this going. And that was 5 years ago.
Wow.
Now, is it true?
6 years, actually.
Now, let me get my stuff right. You were in a role with Halle Berry, correct?
Yeah.
How in the world was that? Because, like, I know you're a kid. But she is, you know, the eyes. See Halle Berry. She's
vintage.
Beautiful. Like, what was that like playing with Halle Berry? Like, how is she? Is she cool? Like, what was it like?
Actually, Halle Berry is, like, the nicest person in the world. Wow. Actually, she's, like... Her, Taraji, and Kelly Rowland are, like, all at the same like, height thing, because they're all super cool, and they're all nice, and Halle Berry was, we got to talking on set because I had known all of my lines, and she was still learning them, and so it was actually kind of funny because I gave her one of her lines. She was like, thank you very much. I was
wow.
Like, you're welcome. But she was really cool. She brings her son on set sometimes.
Oh, wow. So,
yeah.
Wow. How old is her son?
I think when I met him, he was like, I want to say not like maybe two or three months maybe.
Oh, wow. Okay. Sure. Okay.
But she was
yeah,
really
she just
nice.
Had a baby, not that.
Yeah,
not oh, that's she okay.
Yeah.
So yeah, and then my dad came on set with me for Extant, and we were told that Halle wasn't gonna be on set today. And he's like, I'm gonna be cool. I'm gonna be all right. I'm gonna be cool. She's not coming today. Then all of a sudden we hear either the director or the person that does the wardrobe stuff, and he was like. He's like, okay, Mrs. Berry will be on set, and she's approaching right now. My dad was like, oh, God, please. Please, no. And then she came on, and he just couldn't talk. It was hilarious. Wow. I was just like, Dad, you all right?
You're building up a pretty extensive resume.
Absolutely,
you know,
at
an early age. And, you know, I commend you for that. Tell us about Shameless. It was a Showtime series, and... You know, tell us how that whole thing went, because I mean, when you're talking about a series, which you're getting ready to be in one, we'll talk about coming up in a few minutes. But being on a series is a little different from, you know, like a movie. A movie is just it may take time to do it, but a series is consecutive times where you're close to the set and you're pretty much going there every day until you guys get it done. Give us a little bit about what Shameless was, and tell us your experience on that set.
So yeah, I mean, I got on there and I was like, this is gonna be really cool. I'm be with William H. Macy, William H. Macy is really cool. Actually, on set, you would call him Bill.
Okay.
Because apparently that's like what he goes by is Bill. not like William H. Macy or something. It's always like Bill or something.
Yeah, Bill is like short for William, ain't it?
Yeah, it is. Okay. I don't know why, but it is.
So he was really cool, and Emmy Rossum was awesome. She was really nice. Mm-hmm. It was actually funny because when I auditioned, I was like, "New Debbie, do they got this name right? this is a guy role. New Debbie, is that the name?" And they were like, "Yeah, you're gonna be playing the new Debbie in the this part of the season because, you know, it was Frank was getting disowned by his family, his family and." He put together a new family, and he called me New Debbie, and I was like, I'm a boy, though. Yeah, that was pretty cool.
Oh, that's funny.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean, you mentioned that that Lee Daniels inspired you. Inspired you as far as what, you know, wanting to be a producer or a director?
Lee Daniels inspired me because, you know, he's made it so far, and he created Empire, like co-created Empire, and he's director of Star and creator, well, not director, but creator of Star, the new show. And I just think that once my acting career like really kicks off in the future, mm-hmm. I wanna create like shows that make it big like mm-hmm. that. Like mm-hmm. I wanna awesome. Be like Lee Daniels, direct, write, create shows.
Okay. So you really have a passion for the acting and directing thing. Is that from being on set, kind of seeing how things work? Is that something that like are you just, you know, like passionate about? Just movies in general, or just the acting part? Like, what inspired you to want to go in that direction?
I think what really inspired me was seeing how all of the movies were created, and how like behind the scenes, and how directors and how they film. But like going on there, like I thought, you know, if I book stuff, I'll be able to go on there and see what they really do, not just behind the scenes. Mm-hmm. And you know, being with people and going on new shows, like hit shows, it's mm-hmm. like a dream come true. It's really, really cool.
You get butterflies when you like when it's almost time, when you know that they're filming. I mean, like, and also to piggyback on that, like, how many times do you have to do a take? Is it like 50 times, or, you know, do they say, oh, that one's great, you gotta keep doing it over? How is that experience?
So yeah, I mean, there can be a lot of takes. It just depends on what's going on. Like, there's been a time where it was really lucky, but we got this one take done in one shot. Mm-hmm. Because it was so good, and it was the last shot of the day. Mm-hmm. And everybody was super good, and they were like, good, that's a wrap. Nope, last first shot. Let's go.
That's always the best.
There it is.
Like, yeah, sure, no, I'm cool with that.
Yeah.
But then, you know, there have been times where there's been like, I think the most shots we've done on a show is like, I want to say, either 24 or. I'm trying to think. I don't know if it was over 20 or not. I think it was either 12 or 24. I can't remember.
Mm-hmm.
But it was one of those. So
with your script, do you have to like memorize the entire thing and everybody's part, or you just kind of remember your parts and wait for those parts to come?
Really, honestly, you only remember your parts. Like, but before you start memorizing stuff, like what I do is I read through the whole script, so that I can kind of get a feel of what the episode's all about, what my part is going to be about, and at the end, what, you know, what kind of happens and how I can play it out from the beginning to the end, to the middle.
As a kid, that's got to be a lot. I mean, I've seen scripts, and
yeah.
I mean,
it's extensive.
Yeah, you got to you remember yours, but then you also got to remember like who's coming next, and if you see them, you got to be ready to go.
Right. Yeah, they're like, when you memorize in your part, you got to remember the actions so that are being taken before your part and after. So, like, if you're coming in, you got to know how you're coming in. Mm-hmm, or if you're just going to jump in there to a conversation, you got to know how and when, like, at what word they're going to say it. And you just got to be like, oh, yeah. Sometimes it'll be a dot on the other person's line. And that'll obviously tell you when you're supposed to go. But, yeah, I mean, it's not really hard. And coming back to the part where you said do I get butterflies, I really don't get butterflies, because there had been a time where there was like, I performed in like in front of like thousands of people and for a theater or a play, something. And like thousands of people, and I didn't really get nervous because, like, to me, all I see is one person, and that's basically it. Yeah, it's mom.
It's mom. So wow. I always find mama.
Always.
So is it pretty like, cause you're still in school, mm-hmm. and like pilot scenes Gary kick off. So what? Your teachers are like, yo, we just give you all your work. Or what? Like, how does that work? Because you go back and forth from Indy to L.A. and school's still in. Like, it's got to be...
Sometimes if my school's cool enough, they'll send out the work. Because most of the schools now, they go on computer now.
Wow.
So most of the work is on computer.
Oh, cool.
So, you know, at Northview, all of it is on Canvas. And really, all I got to do is log into their daily... my teachers will send me work, and then I'll just do the work, or my mom or dad or person that I'm staying with in LA will print it off. I'll do it, then we take a picture of it and either fax it to them or send it to them in email.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I mean, they didn't do a lot of computer work, like they only did tests for computer stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I had to do homeschool. So I was doing homeschool, but I didn't, I still went to NOR, but I didn't really go to NOR because I was never there, but I still went there, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
So
what do you prefer? You know, in class or just like the road thing where you can do it online?
I like in class because I'm very talkative in class, and I know that's a bad thing, but I mean I like talking to people, and I don't like, because with homeschool, unless you're doing like a homeschool where it's like you obviously go into a classroom, or you're doing homeschool but you go to a classroom with other people in your grade.
Mm-hmm.
So you mean unless you're doing that, there's really nobody else to talk to.
Mm-hmm.
So I mean, I like in class because, you know, sure, on homeschool, once you get your work done, you basically have the whole day. You're not in school for 7 hours. Mm-hmm. You're only in school for 3 hours.
Mm-hmm.
But in that 3 hours, you're also doing a lot of work. You're doing projects that you didn't think you would do in normal school till about the last part of the end of the year. And, yeah.
How's your mom taking all this? I mean, like, you just all of a sudden, like, I'm pretty sure, like, one day she was just like, you were just being an average kid, and now you're, like, all over the place. How's she taking that, being a mom, a parent of an actor, young actor?
I think she's cool with it. I mean, I'm pretty sure
she's pretty laid back about it. I've talked with her a lot about it. Your mom, she's pretty cool. She's pretty laid back. She's kind of like, yo, whatever he wants to do. You know what I mean? We kind of go with that. I know when I was coaching over at her school, we used to talk about it all the time. And she's pretty cool about it. I think she just kind of lets him kind of take the lead if it's what he wants to do. He'll do. But I know that.
That's
that,
awesome.
It's interesting, though, going back and forth to California.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So she's told me some stories about that. So that's pretty interesting, though. It's a grind. Like, a lot of people think, okay, he's on Empire, and he's, like, bigger than the world. And I know some of the backstories where it's, like, it's not what you think.
Oh, wow.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
So,
for sure.
But great kid, though, and great work.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody, and would you agree? Everybody thinks, okay,
yeah,
this is how it is. Like, he's, like, super rich and big.
Yeah, super rich and big. And I'm like, I'm not that rich. They're like, you must be a millionaire if you're on Empire.
Right.
I'm like, sure.
Right. Yeah. Keep thinking that. Keep thinking so.
Hey, but you on your way, man.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you're going in the right direction. And like I said, you got an extensive resume. Shout out to Leslie House. She was assisted in getting us information on you know, some of the things you do, and we've went out there and checked you out. Duke, you know, he's known you and before we have, but I was pretty impressed, you know, because I hadn't met you until today.
Mm-hmm.
And I gotta say, man, I'm impressed. Tell us about Training Day. I mean, that a Training Day was a movie that came out. What year was that?
It was like 01, wasn't it?
01 with Denzel Washington.
Yeah, it was called.
So this series that they're doing is now a spinoff of that. So tell us about that and your role in it.
Training Day was really cool. Bill Paxton was awesome. He was everybody thinks that he's he looks kind of old, but really he doesn't. He he's really strong and he looks really cool on film and stuff, and he was really nice because I was doing my scenes with them, and we came back to Video Village where like everybody's watching the stuff and the director is watching, trying to see what he can see, like what everybody's seeing on TV and how he can fix everything. And he came back and he told everybody, he was like, man, that kid is awesome. Like, he's golden. Like, he keeps stealing every scene that we're in. He's stealing it. I mean, I thought that was really cool of him. So he was really nice.
Yeah. So what was your role in it? Like, what are you doing in the series?
In the series, I'm kind of the kid that kind of shows.
Yeah, he only can talk about so much.
Yeah,
because we want you to tune in, catch the show on CBS.
Watch the show. Absolutely,
catch the show on CBS. Just that's what you tell. That's the go-to line. That's the go-to line. Next time they ask, hey, what are you doing in the show? Tune in to CBS, catch the series.
So tell us when this is airing.
We don't want CBS to come knocking on our door talking about crazy stuff. When does it air? Tell us when it comes on.
You can tell us that. It comes on February 2nd.
Sweet.
At, I think, 8 p.m. On CBS.
That's
10 p.m.
That's a couple weeks away.
Late night. You're going to be asleep. You ain't even going to see it. You're going to be asleep. unless you're in L.A.
If I'm in L.A.
And then it'll be like 7. It'll be 7 o'clock.
At 7, yeah. But if you're here, you're supposed to be asleep getting ready for school.
Wow.
Or you could be up reading another script.
Yeah.
Reading another script. Yeah,
Or I forgot to do my homework and I fell asleep early after I got home.
There
it
is.
I forgot to do my homework. Yeah. Oh, well, guess I can watch Training Day now, right, Mom?
Yeah, there you go. And do your homework at the same time. There you go.
Any future things coming up that you're going to be working on, or you know, because I know as an actor, I mean, you pretty much try and keep stuff on the radar. And how do you approach new things? Like, if you see something out there, do you have a talent scout where that kind of goes out there and says, hey, we got this coming up, you want to go try out for it, or how does that all work?
I really don't have anything coming up right now, just like, you know, getting ready for pilot season. I'll be flying out, and then
explain, you know, pilot season.
So pilot season is when basically all of the pilots come in to.
You mean like people that fly planes?
No. Like, so you know, because
there's people out there like don't know what a pilot is.
Okay,
like,
so every first episode of a series is called the pilot, and they premiere it and they on TV, and if a lot of people watch it or like it, then they continue the series until, you know, people stop watching it. But if the pilot doesn't do good, then nobody's going to pick it up because, you know, nobody's going to want a bad show on their, on their series or on their television network. So, you know, pilot season is when everybody has gotten done with their pilots. They're putting them out there for kids and adults and teenagers to audition for and see which one they like the most. So, you know, I'm just trying to get ready for that.
Is it crazy when you go audition for one of them? Like, is there a line, like, you're in line with, like, 100 people auditioning for one part? Is it, like, crazy like that? Or is it like, oh, you know what? This is Shannon. He comes to the front.
So there have been times where I have... my manager has asked for me to audition for something, and they said no because, you know, they just didn't think that I would fit the role. But there have been times where they have called back in the future and said, look, we have this role. We think that it'll fit Shannon, and we want him to come in and audition for it. But there have been times where you can go online and submit yourself for stuff. and maybe like 500 people will submit themselves for one one thing, and only, or maybe not 500, maybe more than that, like over 1,000. Yeah. And, you know, they'll only bring in a select 100 or lower than that at the most. And they'll bring you in, and if they don't find anybody, then they expand their search and they, you know, do some tinkering with the pilot or whatever you're auditioning for, and they make it so that they think that they might be able to find somebody.
Auditions are wild. I've been on a few auditions for some things. Does it get discouraging when you go on so many auditions and you don't get it? Because a lot of people think, oh, you went on an audition, they think you get the part.
Yeah.
Like, you hear no more than you hear yes, correct?
Yeah. So, you, in Hollywood, you hear, you mostly hear no more than you hear yes at sometimes, because, you know, sometimes you're mostly not what they're looking for, unless, you know, you've looked at the part, you think you can do it, and, you know, they're looking for you and someone like you. There have, like, been times where I've gotten so far in a film or TV show, and, you know, I had everybody, like half of everybody on my team, but then there have been half of other people who have wanted another kid, and they decided to go with the other kid, and so, you know, I was kind of, you know, disappointed on that, so, because it was a really big part, but I didn't get it, so I was really kind of upset about that. But I mean, you get over that kind of stuff, because, you know, if God didn't mean for you to book that one, then, you know, he's got something down the road for you later.
Yeah, absolutely.
Keep that same faith, man.
I wonder what our people got to say. Anybody out there? Anybody?
Miss Butter says, "Who does he look up to?" She wants to know.
I look up to a lot of people. Like I said, when it comes to superhero, you know, Grant Gustin, and you know, those are Terrence Howard, Taraji, Kelly Rowland, Lee Daniels. I think the person that I mostly look up to right now is either between Terrence Howard, Grant Gustin, or Lee Daniels.
Gotcha.
Okay.
Yeah. That's awesome, man. Like I said, man, we're extremely proud of you, dude. I mean, just having you here is awesome. You know what I'm saying? And we hope to, you know, don't get strange on us when the millions, you know, start ringing in, and we gotta get through five people. Can you get a hold of Shannon? Can you get a hold of Shannon?
I know.
Come see us.
Come see us. I'll definitely, you know, I'll be in the future, even if I make it, you know,
when
big
you
time,
make it.
When
even,
I make
when
it,
you
big
make
time.
It.
You will make it.
You're already,
already
made
on,
it.
Yeah. You've already
hold
made
on,
it,
yeah.
Really.
You're there.
You know?
You're there, man.
I'm still going to remember everybody. Like,
for sure.
Everybody who I, in my journey, that has helped me through this acting, and, you know, definitely you guys, I'm obviously going to remember that, because you guys are, like, you guys are one of the reasons that put me up to where I'm going to be.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We appreciate that, man. We appreciate that.
Any other comments from our people out there?
Let's see.
Tuning in live.
No comments yet.
I'm sure some of them people out there want to be actors one day.
Yeah, I mean, like, you know.
At home in front, take twos, 1, 2, 3s, you know what I mean? Shannon, I do want to ask you, though, a lot of acting comes with modeling. Are you into modeling?
I have done a couple of modeling stuff.
Yeah.
I did an Old Navy fashion show at Santa Monica in California.
Sweet. Mm.
So that was pretty cool. And then there have been some times where I did some other Old Navy stuff.
Okay.
And, yeah, so I have done some modeling stuff.
You like it?
Yeah, I mean, modeling's pretty cool. I mean, it's just like acting. You just don't have a lot of lines.
Yeah. So it's easier. It's easier money.
IU, we had another comment. IU Hoosier, let's go, says, Shannon Brown, how do you view the acting industry as a whole?
As a whole?
Yeah, just, I mean, I added as a whole, but, you know, in general, how do you view the acting?
People that are actors, how do you view the industry? Like, what's it like?
Oh.
Is it what you thought it would be?
oh, it's everything that I thought it would be. You know? It's going behind scenes and seeing how everything is made. Like, that's what I thought acting was. And then, you know, you get into it and the lines come. And I sometimes look at people and I see them and they have super long lines. And I'm just like, well, how do you memorize all of that? And, like, they'll, like... There have been times where some of my friends have gotten, like, this thick of a line mm-hmm. and had to memorize it in an hour.
And, wow.
They did it. I mean, it was pretty cool. So.
Wow.
Incredible.
Absolutely.
Man. Again, I just want to remind the viewers who are viewing in, we're, you know, interviewing Brown, who is an emerging actor. He's been in several different series, you know, Personal, Extant on CBS, on Empire for Fox, the Fox series. He was on Showtime, and it's called Shameless. And then he has a new series called Training Day that's going to be airing on CBS on February the 2nd, right, next month. That's coming up in a few weeks, so I'm definitely going to be tuning in.
Tune in 10, yeah. What, 10 p.m. Eastern time?
Yeah.
Yeah, 10 p.m. Perfect. Eastern time. Tune in. Young actor Shannon Brown. Is there anything you want to say to the people out there? You know, people are still getting familiar with you. Mm-hmm. You know, we have a new audience of people that are tuning in to the Gray Area. You know, what do you have to say to the people out there?
I think the most thing that I have to say to the people is, when you want to do something, you go for it, follow your dreams, and don't doubt yourself. And, you know, keep dreaming, because dreaming is what gets you to where you want to be.
Wow.
Sweet.
I mean, that's great.
YCP you know, Global, you might have to put that on a shirt, man.
Yeah, you know, we might have to trademark
might have to put that on a shirt.
You know, you're the first person on our show.
Absolutely, yeah.
Like, you're the very first person on our show. You know that, right?
Really?
Yeah.
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 Cool.
So I was like, yo, let's bring Shannon on. You're the first person on the show. This is our second show. You're the first person on the show.
Yeah,
so
we launched this on January 1st, yeah. And it was a blessing to have you come on and bless it.
Yeah.
So we
absolutely,
thank you.
Man.
Follow your dreams. Follow your dreams. Keep dreaming.
Keep it up, man.
And we're going to keep pushing you, all right?
Thank you.
Hey, don't give up on that basketball, man, because, you know, check this out. Them jokers on the West Coast can't hoop like we do in the Midwest. So you need to get in that lab, bro.
From Indiana, you got to show them what's happening.
Tell them on set, bro. You need the basketball.
Yeah. Keep shooting that ball.
You get your own trailer?
What do you mean?
Like, on set, like, you get your own trailer.
Sometimes, like, you'll, like, it's not like, you know, your own trailer where it's, like, super big. Like, sometimes, if it's, like, a small role, you'll get kind of, like, a small little room with a couch and a bathroom.
Right. Well, you make sure you keep that basketball with you, bro. All times. Don't be misrepresenting the Midwest when you out there with that rock, boy. Because you know they can't hoop like we do. No. You know what I'm saying? They can't hoop like
represent
we do.
Indiana.
Like, put that thing down when you get out there, man. So
yes, sir.
Man, am I signing off?
Hey, yeah, we're getting ready to sign off. I want to say again. Oh, wait a minute. We got another comment. Papat wants to know: did other kids make fun of you or not?
No kids really made fun of me. I mean, I think most kids were kind of, you know, in awe of what I've been on. Like, I don't think a lot of kids make fun of me. I don't think so.
The jealousy hasn't set in yet, huh? That's cool. It's good. But it's coming. No. Yeah. The jealousy's coming, brother. People are going to hate, so just be ready. When they hate, though, you just keep moving.
Oh, he seemed like he ain't even worried.
Smile and wave.
He ain't even worried about the haters.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, just keep going, man.
Keep it moving.
And that's
man.
Good.
Keep it moving.
We're proud of you, man.
Yeah.
Very proud of you, brother. Yeah.
I remember when you was little and your mom was talking about it, and she first told me about your first commercial and stuff. I was like, wow, let's keep it up. Mm-hmm. So, your boy Duke, all I can say is, man, to a young person such as yourself or anybody else out there, just keep striving, keep doing what you do. I appreciate the people that tuned in. You know my motto is real simple. Don't be good, be great. You know what I'm saying? Everything you do, just be great at it, because you got to remember, and the reason why I say be great is if you slip while you're trying to be great, you're going to slip to good. But if you be good all the time and you slip, you're going to be below average.
Mm-hmm.
Feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Some of y'all going to pick up on that later, you know what I mean? Because average is just right there, you know what I mean? So if you great and you slip, you go back to good. But if you good in slip, you below average. You know what I mean? Now you got to crawl that much further to get back to the top. So my message to y'all, like I said, don't be good, be great.
It is.
Good, man. Hey, P. Wills signing off. Listen, it has been a pleasure, man, to sit here and, you know, meet you and talk to you. Very proud of you, man. You know, can't say that enough. You know, you're representing us, man. You know, the city. This is, you know, part of the reason why we created this platform, man. So if I could tell you anything else, you know, just stay positive, man, through everything. You know, just keep striving, man. Just keep pursuing your dreams. And like he said, man, basketball-wise, hey, look, I used to live out there. Man, bust him. Give it to him. Give it to him. Shoot that ball. Seriously. Nah, but seriously, man, you know, man, just keep it up, man. Just keep it up.
Thank you.
Hey, well, I've told you probably 100 times during this segment, man, you are a blessing to the show. Thank you for coming on. You know, what I want to say to, you know, all the kids out there is to, you know, use Shannon Brown as an example to say that you can do it. No dream is unattainable. Everything is attainable. Go out there, keep it up. And also to the parents, you know, I can't say your mom is awesome, you know, to be able to say, hey, let's pack up and let's just go and do this for you. Mm-hmm. You know, it takes a lot of heart to, you know, just stop what you're doing and put something like that, because you just don't know where you're laying. Everything is a risk. Yeah. So I'll say to the parents, if you see a kid, you know, with the talent level, and this is obviously you're natural. I mean, you sat here and talked to us mm-hmm. this whole time. I talk to kids, and they don't get through 10 minutes, you know, without going to have to use the bathroom. So, I mean, that just shows, but that just shows you right there your mm-hmm. your natural talent and ability to sit here and talk and listen to the questions that we're asking and mm-hmm. to answer them. That's mega. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? And for a kid yeah. at your age. So I'll say, keep it going. Use Shannon Brown as an example to attain your dreams. And, you know, this is the gray area. And we'll holler at you guys again. Thanks for tuning in.